Dear friends, humanity is on thin ice, and that ice is melting fast.
Actions in this decade are critical for securing a sustainable future for all.
Hundreds of the world's top scientists have spent 8 years compiling absolutely everything we know about climate change.
We will probably reach 1.5 degrees.
We can't take back the impacts that would have already happened at that warming level.
We will suffer more in the future.
A real threat to human and planetary well-being.
And the resulting IPCC synthesis report dropped today.
It is a survival guide for humanity.
The steps are simple. Cut fossil fuel funding immediately, then phase out coal, then achieve net zero electricity generation, and then global net zero, no ifs, buts, or maybes, by 2050. Basically everything we were going to do, starting now instead of soon.
We really only have a decade, maybe even less.
But we've heard this song many times before and it just doesn't seem to cut through. Which might be why the UN Secretary General tried to spice things up with pop culture references.
Our world needs climate action on all fronts. Everything, everywhere, all at once.
Sucked into a bagel.
And by deploying his most powerful metaphors.
Today's IPCC report is a how-to guide to defuse the climate time bomb.
So while the instructions are clear and the danger speaks for itself, will it be enough to change our tune?
The future really is in our hands.
But it will take a quantum leap in climate action.
I wouldn't say it's impossible, but I would say it's highly improbable.
Hope for the future, where did you go?
Well, that's sobering, isn't it?
Isn't it, right? Yeah. So the next report is released in 2030, right?
Yeah.
We've been talking about climate since 2006 when An Inconvenient Truth came out. Do you remember Al Gore?
I remember that. The guy with seven houses and the private jet.
But what's changed? Like, we've been talking about it and talking about it, and we're still no closer to meeting these targets.
Yeah, when you look at that roadmap, it's... Because the big one that I looked at and thought, how do you do that, is global net zero. Because you're starting to see in the developed world, so, you know, wealthy countries, that emissions are starting to drop. But the developing world, you tell them to drop their emissions and they say, well, how many of our people do you want to kill in the meantime while we try to feed them? Yeah. And I just, it's a really hard riddle for us to solve, because when you think about the way human beings work, what threats do we respond to? Threats that are like immediate and graphic and concrete. And when you get something that is like 100 years away and a bit abstract and requires a lot of sacrifice in the short term for something like...
Correct. And everybody wants a fridge.
Yes, exactly.
Do you know what I mean? If you've lived without a fridge is a miracle to you and you want it and then your neighbours want it.
Yeah.
Can the world give everyone a fridge?
Yeah, not easily. Yeah.